If your sample is a thin film on a substrate or an ion irradiated material, conventional Bragg-Brentano XRD may probe too deeply beneath the surface for you to study the region of your material that is interesting. As shown in the left panel, the X-rays interact with the substrate much more than a thin film, which is reflected in the diffraction pattern as a weak contribution from the thin film and a strong contribution from the substrate. With knowledge of the expected composition and density of your material, however, we can estimate the penetration depth of the X-rays as a function of omega, which is the angle at which the X-rays strike your sample. This helps to ensure that you only study the depth of your sample that is most interesting to you. As shown in the right panel, we can then hold the incident angle constant while the detector rotates through 2 theta, thereby keeping the penetration depth constant throughout the experiment. This is called Grazing-incidence X-ray diffraction. Our users regularly utilize this technique for phase identification, lattice parameter calculation, and the determination of the crystallinity of their samples. In a moment, I'll show you a real example of data collection from 40 to 50 degrees 2 theta using both Bragg-Brentano and grazing incidence configurations. But first, I'd like to point out some of the different parts of the diffractometer. On the left is the X-ray source, and on the right is the detector. In the center is the sample. All of the other stuff in the X-ray path is used to condition the beam. We can use different configurations to control the size of the X-ray footprint on the sample, how spread out the beam is, etc. Here you see the system in the Bragg-Brentano configuration, so the source and detector both begin at 20 degrees, which makes a starting 2 theta angle of 40 degrees. They then rotate at the same rate upward by 5 degrees, which makes an end angle of 50 degrees. This results in a very weak peak. Now we go to the grazing incidence configuration. The source moves to an angle of 4 degrees while the detector moves to 36 degrees. The detector then moves upward by 10 degrees and we see that the peak is larger. We now remain in the grazing incidence configuration, but the grazing angle is reduced to 1 degree and the detector moves to 39 degrees. Again, the detector rotates by 10 degrees to bring the total end angle to 50 degrees, and we see the peak intensity has continued to increase. Finally, the grazing angle is reduced to half a degree, and as you'll see in a moment, the peak intensity increases further. Now, in case I'm leading you to believe that the peak will continue to get larger as you decrease the angle, there is some angle at which the X-rays no longer penetrate into the material and you stop seeing peaks altogether. If you would like more information about the JIAM diffraction facility or have any questions, here is the address for our website and my email address. Thank you for watching.